Hey, have you ever put your mobile phone next to the radio? Ever wondered what is the sound the two of them make when put next to each other? Listen, they're jamming! Something in the phone operates with the same frequency as radios.
Such frequency duets might be great for art projects, but can quickly lead to accidents when there is an interference between your car's GPS system and your pacemaker, which goes into overdrive. Will my heart go on? But where to?
First, let's change the frequency. Let's move inside our lab to see what is going on. All electrical and electronic devices generate electromagnetic interferences and are susceptible to them. Most devices we use have some sort of an electrical component, and different parts must coexist without affecting each other's operation. And that is where EMC comes in. EMC stands for Electromagnetic Compatibility. Enter EMC. Electronic parts must meet EMC requirements for immunity so that the product components are protected from the environment and in accordance with EMC emissions to ensure that your product is not intentionally radiating into environment, in and out. But how exactly does it work? What does the EMC testing look like? Here I have a device, which will lead me to the strongest electromagnetic knowledge point, to the SIQ. Let's go!
Whew. My machine is sensing that the field is getting stronger and stronger. Whoa! The tide is rising. We have more power.
Hello.
Hello.
My machine senses that the field is the strongest here.
Yes, I know.
Could you tell me something about EMC?
Yes, of course. Let's have an interview.
Whew. The force is strong in this interview. I'm here with Mr. Marian Mack. He's the head of EMC laboratory for 15 years now. Mr. Marian, what kind of products do you test?
From a cell phone to the power plant and everything in the industrial, commercial, automotive and medical industry. Products such as household appliances, lights, railway equipment, gaming devices and so on.
How do we know when something is EMC compatible?
If you see an SIQ logo on medical equipment, do not worry. Super special tests like voltage dips, proximity fields and ESD have been conducted so the dentist can make your smile more confident.
What does the EMC testing look like?
First, you need a state-of-the-art and also very expensive lab, as well as highly qualified engineers. The initial step in EMC testing is placing the device into an EMC chamber and applying electromagnetic field while observing the device. If the device is too sensitive to electromagnetic field, it is not yet ready for the market.
According to how many standards do you test and how many new standards are introduced annually?
More than 100 different standards, which are continuously updated with additional requirements. So we cooperate in standardization committees and also regularly train our employees.
Mr. Marian, thank you very much.
You're welcome.
Your field is great.
Thank you.
If you have a vision to create a device, it is necessary to conduct the EMC test before you put the product on the market. If something goes wrong, you might get sued and even locked up. You could conduct the EMC test for yourself, but that would be a major investment and probably you don't have that amount of money. Hello, where can I find the EMC laboratory? Yeehaw! Ooh, yes, we have finally found it. The laboratory. We are almost EMC compatible. Let's go! Whoa! This baby will cost you a couple of thousands of dollars. But currently I'm in a $1 million lab where experts test electromagnetic compatibility. The signal goes through the antenna to the receiver, where numbers are verified so they are in accordance with the country's regulations and standards. When conformity is achieved and your SIQ stamp is obtained, it is official that your device can coexist with the environment and other devices in a perfect electrical harmony. Happily ever after. If you like science, how things work and how they are tested, don't forget to click subscribe with the bell aside for more cool videos. Thank you for watching. See you!